Hello, and welcome back to Magma Storm. The Grand Canyon is one of the most fascinating places on planet Earth. Its deep ravines, beautiful landscape, and breathtaking rock formations are truly magnificent works of nature. The area is known around the world for its beauty. But did you know that various archaeological discoveries have begun to rewrite the entire history of the region? In this video, we'll explore 9 unusual and remarkable discoveries made in the Grand Canyon, ranging from Egyptian hieroglyphics to ancient Native American settlements. Number 9. The Ancient 500-Pound Sloth. The Grand Canyon is notable for its vast array of peaking sandstone cliffs and rock formations. However, not everyone knows many cliffs have caves embedded in them. Many of these caves are full of plants and animal remains, which shed light on the history of the region and its biodiversity. These caves would have once been the perfect habitat for a selection of animals, including wood rats, sloths, bats, and the now-extinct mountain goats. As Arizona is known for its exceptionally dry climate, the bones of many of these animals have been preserved fairly well. This remarkable level of preservation has allowed researchers to gain insights into events that would have taken place in the region over 40,000 years ago, during the last major ice age. One of the more significant finds in the area was discovered in the Rampart Cave, which sits at an elevation of over 536 meters at the western end of the canyon. Within this cave, researchers came across several piled-up collections of dung that looked as if they had been excreted in recent years. However, this led researchers to discover that the dung had, in fact, been left by a now-extinct 9-foot-long and 500-pound sloth. The enormous sloth has now been extinct for well over 10,000 years. Number 8. Unusual Prehistoric Life Form. A few years ago, an enormous rock came tumbling down from a cliff in the Grand Canyon. Luckily, no one was in the immediate area as it fell. The boulder itself likely sat for some time until one geologist named Alan Krill went hiking through the Grand Canyon and spotted something weird in the corner of his eye. As he approached the fairly large boulder, he noticed some unusual markings on it. As Krill moved closer to the rock, he realized that these markings were, in fact, small fossilized footprints. The intrigued geologist took various pictures of the unusual fossil, and would later send them to his friend and colleague, Stephen Roland, a well-revered paleontologist. Roland went on to analyze the pictures sent to him by his friend, and he suggested that these were, in fact, footprints of some unknown prehistoric animal that could be up to 313 million years old. A sketch was later drawn up of what the animal may have looked like, and researchers believed it to be an amniote, a hard-shelled, egg-laying animal that once thrived in the area hundreds of millions of years ago. Others have suggested that it was from a tetrapod. But regardless, the fossilized footprints in the sandstone made them the oldest evidence of any kind of vertebrate that once lived in the Grand Canyon. Number 7. Egyptian Carvings in the Grand Canyon. One story that has remained in the headlines for decades is the discovery of what seems to be Egyptian hieroglyphs in the vicinity of the Grand Canyon. In March of 1909, the Phoenix Gazette published 2 stories about discovering a great underground citadel hidden in a cave in the Grand Canyon. The first story mentions only G.E. Kincaid and his explorations along and down the Colorado River. The paper did say that Kincaid made various archaeological discoveries, yet no details were given. However, in the second edition of the story, the paper spoke of Kincaid's discoveries, which included a supposed ancient settlement that once existed in hand-carved caves. The Southwest is home to many Pueblo ruins and cities belonging to many different tribes of the Pueblo people. However, Kincaid described the city as resembling something from either Egypt or Asia. Kincaid went on to claim that there were hand-carved tunnels and caves containing a hoard of items. These included mummies, a shrine with a figure sitting cross-legged holding a lotus flower, the hieroglyphic writings, and war weapons and copper instruments with sharpened edges as hard as steel. Kincaid estimated that 50,000 people had once lived in the tunnels and caves. While the newspaper article initially reported that the Smithsonian joined in on the expedition and even studied the site themselves, No modern records can prove this. So, was the story nothing more than a hoax? Well, maybe not. We know that the first explorer in the region, John Wesley Powell, noted various caves in the Grand Canyon on his way down the Colorado River. On top of this, he reported the discovery of well-worn paths, ruins, hieroglyphs of some kind, and pottery fragments. In the years since Powell's discovery, the Grand Canyon has been the site of extensive study. Archaeologists have discovered over 400 Native American sites, with some dating back as far as 12,000 years ago. Is it possible that Kincaid was simply mistaken in his identification of the origins of the cave? Indeed, it is. However, one must wonder at the description of mummies and the Asian influence that Kincaid mentions in the newspaper article. Want your history served up with a side of extraordinary? Then subscribe to Magma Storm for a buffet of the bizarre and fascinating. Number 6. Uranium deposits in the Grand Canyon. The Grand Canyon has been a spiritual and cultural center for various Native Americans for thousands of years. Today, it remains as such for at least 11 tribes, who still use the area during ritual practices and ceremonies. One would think that a place of such significance would be protected from uranium contamination, yet this is not the case. There are multiple uranium mines and hundreds of mining claims located outside the boundaries of the park, and they pose a serious threat to the preservation of the area. Uranium deposits are generally found within layers of siltstone, sandstone, and occasionally mudstone throughout the southwestern portion of the United States. In the Grand Canyon and the surrounding area, miners discovered large uranium deposits in geological formations known as breccia pipes. This region has been attracting miners since the 19th century, yet uranium mining only began in the area during the 1950s. Operations first started at Orphan Mine, an area less than a few kilometers from Canyon Village. One currently active mine, known as Pinyon Plain Mine, poses a serious threat to the natural springs within the Grand Canyon. During the mid-2000s, the price of uranium significantly increased, prompting many companies to flock to the Grand Canyon region to reach this mineral. By the end of the decade, the number of mining permits had reached the thousands in the lands surrounding the Grand Canyon National Parks. Yet local governments, local hunters, and various Native American communities were quick to act. And a successful campaign managed to ban uranium mining in the surrounding area for 20 years. This greatly benefited the Havasupai tribe, whose reservation lies within the depths of the canyon. They depend on the spring-fed creek that flows through their village, providing fresh water for drinking and cooking. The Havasupai expressed their concern that the uranium mining would pollute the underground water that feeds to the spring. Yet, to date, there are still over 600 active mining claims on national forest and public lands in the vicinity of the Grand Canyon. And only time will tell whether or not they are given a chance to again mine for the toxic uranium. Number 5. Unusual and strange petroglyphs. Petroglyphs and rock art are frequently observed throughout the Grand Canyon, as many ancient civilizations left their imprints on the canyon walls. While they're not exactly the most unusual things found in the Grand Canyon, they're undeniably some of the most fascinating in a historical sense. These ancient artworks provide insight into the history and culture of the people who inhabited the area well before the arrival of European explorers. Some of the art dates back over 10,000 years to the Archaic period. The oldest petroglyphs in the Grand Canyon consist of abstract designs and geometric shapes, and are often found in remote and inaccessible locations. Some of the most fascinating petroglyphs in the Grand Canyon are found in an area known as Shaman's Gallery. These multicolored paintings are exceptionally fragile, and it is believed they were painted before 1000 BC. Many of the images are life-sized, painted in layers, and all are excitingly elaborate. The paintings were discovered by mule wrangler and guide Gordon Smith in 1986, and thus are often called Gordon's Panel. The petroglyphs in the Grand Canyon have played a huge role in giving archaeologists and researchers a fair understanding of the tribes who once lived here. While many are simple depictions of humans and animals, others portray images that are yet to be deciphered and continue to spark the imagination of researchers from around the world. Number 4. the Great Unconformity. The Grand Canyon contains various myths surrounding its ancient past and origins. Some see it as a spiritual place that's been a holy site for thousands of years, and others believe its origins could have a hidden past. One such feature that further adds to the mystery of this area is a geological feature known as the Great Unconformity. The Great Unconformity is best explained as an unusual absence of millions, if not billions of years of rock layers in the geological record. This has created an unusually significant discontinuity in the rock sequence, and has left researchers scratching their heads as they try to explain the missing layers of rock. Within the Grand Canyon, scientists working in the area have claimed that the Great Unconformity is observed between two distinct layers of rock. Firstly, the Vishnu Schist, which goes back over 1.7 billion years, and the Tapete Sandstone, which is approximately 525 million years old. The missing 1.2 billion years represents a crucial and unusual part of the Earth's history. There are various theories on why such an extensive period of the rock's history is missing, and they are still a topic of ongoing debate. This just adds to the many unexplainable parts of the Grand Canyon's history. Number 3. Split twig figurines. There are various telltale signs of the cultures that once lived in the vast territory of the Grand Canyon. Archaeologists who have worked in the area have come across a wide variety of shelters, tools, pottery, and jewelry. Yet, some of the most fascinating items that have been recovered from various parts of the Grand Canyon are the split twig figurines. The figurines are generally made from willow twigs that have been split down the middle and then carefully manufactured into the shapes of animals. Two of the most common shapes resemble deer or bighorn sheep. Some even have horns and antlers. These ornamental pieces have been found in dry caves, mostly in and around the Great Basin, but also on the Colorado Plateau. Their discovery was first recorded by adventurers traveling around the Grand Canyon in 1933. Since then, archaeologists have estimated that many of the figurines could be up to 4,000 years old. While their exact function still remains a mystery to researchers, some have suggested they could be religious totems associated with archaic hunter-gatherers of the region. One thing is for sure, they were not toys. Most of the twig figurines were found under rock cairns, suggesting careful placement, and that they most likely held some kind of spiritual significance to the culture that placed them there. Number 2. The Mugion Monster. One of the most intriguing tales told about the Grand Canyon is the legend of the Mugion Monster, which locals refer to as Arizona's Bigfoot. This particular group of monsters is said to live in the densely forested region of the Mugion Rim, a 2,000-foot cliff that stretches from northern Yavapai County to New Mexico's border. These ape-like monsters have been spotted in the Mugion region and close to the Grand Canyon for over a century, with the first coming back in 1903. The first recorded sighting comes to us from the explorer Walter Stevens. Walter claims he had an encounter with the beast and gives a fairly in-depth description. In his report, Walter called it a large, hairy, humanoid monster with piercing red eyes. This description bears a great similarity to the legendary Sasquatch or Bigfoot. Walter went on to say the humanoid possessed a remarkable level of stealth, and it was able to move effortlessly through the rugged terrain of the Mugion Rim. Numerous other sightings have occurred over the last 100 years. While many of the descriptions given by the people who have witnessed the beast bear great similarities, this hasn't convinced most scientists who have examined the evidence. Scientists generally ascribed these claims to either a fake account or simply a large standing grizzly bear. As this creature's existence is yet to be proven to this day, if you ever hear a harrowing scream along the rugged Mugion Trail, it might be in your best interest to run, and don't look back. Number 1. Tucson Ruins. Ancient settlements can be found in various places all over the Grand Canyon, from sites of habitation close to the Colorado River to vast cave networks that would have provided shelter. Signs of life are apparent all over the landscape. One of the most fascinating people who had lasting roots in the Grand Canyon is the ancestral Puebloans. They are cited as the relatives of the modern-day Hopi, Zuni, and other Puebloan peoples. One of the best-preserved sites of these ancient peoples is known as the Tucson Ruins, located on the southern edge of the Grand Canyon. The site was built around the year 1185 CE, but some researchers believe this date could be pushed back much further. The settlement consists of homes, communal buildings, agricultural fields, and even religious structures. All of this evidence points towards a rather large and established settlement that once thrived there. The ruins contain two kivas, otherwise known as ceremonial structures. The Puebloans still use these to this day. They are built in a circular fashion and are only accessible through holes in the roof. The Hopi speak of legends passed down through the ancestral line that they entered the world through a kiva. To this day, the Tucson ruins remain one of the best preserved and most studied settlements of ancient Native Americans in the Grand Canyon. And that's our 9 extraordinary and unusual discoveries from the Grand Canyon. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to leave a like, share, and subscribe to Magma Storm for more intriguing historical explorations. Leave a comment below to tell us which of these unusual finds from the Grand Canyon intrigued you the most.